Do plants get sick? Or even crazier, can they self-destruct?
Light, air, water, nutrients, and of course food are essential to a plant's survival. But do you know what else they need? The ability to defend themselves.
Defend against what exactly? Well, a lot of things, one of which is diseases. So yes, plants can get sick.
Just like humans, plants get sick because of pathogens, microorganisms which are agents of disease. In plant pathology, they are divided into bacteria, viruses, fungi, and nematodes.
So how will the plant defend itself then?
The answer lies on their immune system, which is how we humans also fight back. But there's a difference. Our immune system works like a mall, filled with people. Then suddenly, a threat emerges. Security guards on standby will act against the threat. As for plants, everyone in the mall is able to do so. Plant cells use pattern recognition receptors found on their membranes, which are basically detectors for foreign molecules called pathogen-associated molecular patterns, or PAMPs. Detection of these PAMPs triggers a series of defense responses, leading to PAMP-triggered immunity. But a pathogen can answer back with effector proteins to counter this immunity. However, plants develop resistance genes that encode NBS LRR proteins to counter this attack. This activates a new kind of immunity, effector-triggered immunity. The plant cell then commits suicide.
Wait, what?
The infected cell basically commits suicide to stop the spread of disease and kill off the pathogen. This is known as the hypersensitive response.
So to an extent, they can self-destruct, though their cells only. But pathogens aren't the only threats to plants.
Insert herbivores, plant-eating organisms. They use physical traits like barks and waxy cuticles as their first line of defense, called mechanical defenses, which can even prevent the entry of pathogens. Structures like thorns, spines, and trichomes, which can induce damage, are also included. For chemical defenses, plants can produce secondary metabolites, compounds which can deter herbivores with some being toxic. Did you know that they can even form alliances with other species? By releasing volatile chemicals in the air, they attract enemies of their own enemies, like a wasp that can attack caterpillars. Neighboring plants can even pick up on these airborne signals, triggering them to produce their own repellents.
These are only some of the ingenious ways a plant can defend itself, with more out there. And it only goes to show that one should not underestimate a plant. And I guess it's safe to conclude that a plant sure does have more tricks up its sleeves. Thanks for watching.